an incredible experience. I don't even think that's the right word. Overwhelming, emotional event to sit here and make music and to listen to you wonderful people bring to life my music. You know, for a composer, it really just exists on a piece of paper until you sit with a fantastic orchestra like the London Symphony and a fantastic conductor like Ira, and then my soloist who must slave and at times love hate me for all the I'm a kidney stone.
That's a phrase I use for what I call a tough passage. I call it a kidney stone.
Ah, a tough passage.
Because it's a tough passage.
And I think Anastasia had at least two kidney stones while working with me. Slightly different question for you as the guitar soloist. Guitar is not used as much with orchestras as violins that are shrill and loud, and pianos that are, let's not talk about pianos. How do you feel about that, playing an instrument that's inherently soft?
I love playing that instrument that is inherently soft. However, I'll be the first to admit it is a treacherous minefield to put a guitar in front of a symphony orchestra, no matter how great the orchestra and how great the conductor. And the responsibility on the composer is enormous to make that work. And I must say, in the case of working with Michael, that he has been most accommodating for any changes and suggestions that are going to make this thing produce the result that we're all hoping for. Leonard Bernstein once said in the Harvard lectures, he said, every composer spends his life writing the same piece. I don't find that in this circumstance. And frankly, what little bit I know about all of your music, I've just learned so much about you through the Goyescana and the Guitar Concerto. And I just think it is a wonderful work that just absolutely must find its way into the repertoire. So it's been a real thrill for me, privilege to be working with these great musicians, a fabulous conductor, incredible composer, and then all these wonderful technical support people that are going to make this happen. So it's been a process.
Maybe there should be no definitive performance of any piece of music ever. Is that?
I've got to say, some of the little things that I'm sure you've done in your solo part will always be in a performance of the violin concerto. And some of my little nuances that I have in Goyescana, no matter how personal they may be, they're going to wind up at least hinted at in every subsequent performance of that piece, simply because the standard has been set. First hearing cannot help but become a definitive performance.
This is why you have to keep writing a lot of new music. Otherwise, we'll get bogged down like bees forever, enmeshed in a piece of amber later to be found. I have to admit, I'm always surprised by one thing. I'm surprised by just how magical music is. It always strikes me that when you play great music, it is so much more real than reality. I don't know why.
That's a good note to end on.